The reason I did Scarface, or how it came to my attention as I was watching the old Paul Muni film about 3 o'clock one morning when I couldn't sleep, or one evening when I couldn't sleep, and it occurred to me that a film like that, a film like Scarface, the rise and fall of an American gangster, had not been done, certainly not been done recently. Haven't been done since Scarface. And having had done a number of films with Pacino, I'd always wanted to do a large gangster film where he would have a part to play in this genre. And it occurred to me that this was not the old Scarface, because the old Scarface had to do with Prohibition. And I sort of talked to other people. One of the people I talked to was Sidney Lumet. Sidney, who I had done two films with, thought about it and immediately came up. He says, "Well, why don't you do this about the cocaine war?" And the first thing I said, that's it. And I enlisted Oliver, who I'd known for a long, long time. We were very good friends. And we embarked on this venture, this quest, to explore the cocaine world.
It's a good idea, I thought. And that was interesting because there were all kinds of factors in the Cuban immigration, you know, social factors, and it applied to contemporary America, not like, you know. Of course, there was always the parallel between the drug thing and the prohibition thing. I mean, drugs, in a sense, are treated like alcohol was early in the century. Prohibited. And prohibited has led to all kinds of excesses and creations of gangster elements, you know, and fortunes have been made.
That Bregman had developed with Stone was completely different. Nothing I had ever envisioned, and that's why I liked it so much, because it was a whole new way of approaching this material. And those elements were in the original script. I liked the material specifically because, to me, it was sort of like a modern metaphor for the treasure of Sierra Madre, where cocaine becomes gold and it's a kind of the American dream gone crazy, where you have this product that you can turn into millions of dollars, but in the process you destroy your life. And it's sort of like the capital.